And right now at 5, team coverage of the firefight that's still going on tonight. I'm Paul Folger.
And I'm Jessica Schambach. We'll start with Eyewitness News 5's Mark Opgren. And Mark, you're about to get some new information.
That's right. Major Tim Wheeler with the Edmond Fire Department said in about 5 minutes from now, he says he's going to have some new information. But let me tell you the latest information on the fire. You can see back there that it's still smoking, what's left of the apartment complex here. They've been trying to battle this all day, throwing water on it, trying to get this thing out, because the investigation is ongoing right now. But until they get all of it out, investigators can't go in. Like a lot of people who watch this apartment complex smolder throughout the day, Alan Curley has a lot of questions.
Makes you wonder how a building like this just starts on fire in the middle of a Monday night. You know, it's pretty weird.
Edmond Fire investigators are already searching for answers. Throughout the day, they interviewed workers and witnesses, but they can't pound the ground for clues until the fire is out and cool, and that may take a while. Two trucks poured water on hot spots all day long. Parts that still stood were still on fire.
These guys work really hard. They know what they're doing.
Firefighters have now spent 24 hours at the scene. They say they will be here as long as it takes to put it out. And in fact, as we said, they are still here. There's actually two of those trucks. They've been pouring water on some of those spots where you can see all that smoke out there right now. It's been taking them all day long, like they said, about 24 hours to try to get this whole thing contained. You know, until they get it all contained, that's the only part that they need to get before the investigators can actually get inside and complete that investigation. In fact, like we said, just in a few minutes now, we're going to try to get some more information from the fire department. We're live in Edmond. Mark Opgren, Eyewitness News 5.